Good morning. Today's practice is really coming back to basics. This is a series of Facebook Live videos that you might be watching me live or recording on Facebook. You might be watching this on IGTV or on YouTube. I've been doing these since March the 15th when all of things started to really change. And I want to come back to basics with this one because a lot more people are watching this and I just want you to know what this is all about. So what we've got here and where my focus is I want to teach you the awareness of your body parts and how you're actually moving and where those body parts are in space. Because when you're not aware or you of what's going on, you can't change what's going on. So a lot of people who follow this feed are people who have pain and want to get out of pain, or they've gotten out of pain to a certain amount and they want to get to that next level, which is why I call this from pain to possibility. So then what do you want to do next after you're out of pain, right? But a lot of times people get themselves into a bit of a space because they've gotten out of pain, but they forget all of what they've just gained and they just push and they just go for whatever they want to go for without the awareness that they already gained as a foundation, okay? So this is really for two groups of people, those of you who have pain and you want to help yourself out of pain, and those of you who are now, you're getting more and more experiences of having less and less pain following these, and you're now wanting the next thing. So I just want to remind you to keep coming back to how your body is moving, and this practice will be about how your leg bone moves in your pelvis, how your arm bones move in your shoulder socket, for you to gain awareness of what's going on in your body, because it comes back to you, comes back to me, comes back to ourselves practicing. All right, so let's give this a whirl. Now, if after this you want to get more help from me outside of just a recorded video, send me a direct message or comment below, okay? So let's begin. We're going to begin here with feet on the floor in Tadasana and just notice where you're at today. It's June 3rd, I think, or 4th, one of those two. I don't quite remember. The days all kind of move all together. There's a lot of worldly events going on right now. So I want you to feel, that's number one. I want you to feel how your body is. You might be joining me at 5 a.m., which is when I record this, or it might be later in the day for you, but wherever you're at, I want you to feel where you are, where your body is, and how you have been with your day, and how your day has been with you, how your sleep has been with you, and just how you are overall with what is going on in the world and how you're responding. Notice the feeling that is there, yeah? And then feel your feet, center of the heel, ball of the foot, base of the pinky toe. Try not to pull those shoulders back. Try not to lift the ribs, just be where you are. Get really real about where you are at now. Okay, and let's take the shoulders. So shoulders are going to come up, and they're going to come back, and they're going to come down. So the articulating joints are shoulder, arm bone in the shoulder socket, blades on the rib cage. Sometimes people will get the ribs involved, or sometimes people will get the arms generating the movement. Let's try to keep those pieces quiet. Not anchored, but just quiet. See if you can just allow the shoulders to lift and then come back. Blades are retracting. And then notice yourself breathing. Notice whatever clicketing and clacketing and crunching, whatever is there, yeah? And then let's add some breathing. So you're going to inhale on the way up, exhale back and then down. Inhale on the way up, exhale back and down. Good. Inhale on the way up, exhale back and down. Good. Easy, 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 easy breathing. Okay, lovely. Now we're going to take the legs wide. The legs are coming wide, abduction, right? So the key here is that our pelvis is staying level right here. Okay, so if I bring the legs back, I can feel my hands on the iliac crest and I can can take my legs wide. Then I'm going to rotate my leg bones. Lots of times in yoga, we talk about moving the toes out, but I want you to focus in on the leg bone and the hip socket, because the toes are moving out because of what's happened at the leg bone and the hip socket. Okay, so pay attention to that and notice what's going on. I'm holding the wall behind me just so you can get a real look at that leg bone in the pelvis. Okay, if I bring the skeleton over here, it's this motion here, right? So we're just moving this bone. Now you might not be able to move very far, and that's the whole point of what we're doing today's practice, is really to notice what you've got. So maybe you thought you had a lot more than you did. And so it's like, oh, look at that. This is what I have. Good. And then from here, we're just going to start to do a little bit of a bend, articulating joint is hip, knee, and ankle. Yeah. So then all of a sudden you might realize, oh my gosh, you know what? Like, my movement is really not nearly what I thought it was. Now you might not say with such lightness, oh my gosh, you may actually say, holy shit, this is like nothing. You've got to be kidding. That's my movement. Or you might even say something a little bit more leveled up in terms of motion around, oh my, you have got to be kidding. That's what my movement is. And that answer, I can't see you, but the answer is most likely, possibly, yes. And then if you have pain, you go, oh, okay, maybe that's a contribution, or maybe there's a correlation between how I am moving and what I am feeling. Yeah? So find the range of motion where you're not increasing pain. Find the range of motion where you're actually moving through your hips and your knees and your ankles. Like, what can sometimes happen is that when people start to move and they don't have the range at the hip to do the movement, they'll come in here and do this with their pelvis like this. They'll do something like this. Now, of course, I'm mimicking it. This is not one of my patterns, but this might be what you notice, right? And so instead of doing the movement from the hips, you do the movement from your back, right? And that's, we don't want that. We want to actually have, if your intent is to move your leg bones into rotation, if your intent is to move your leg bones in rotation, let's move your leg bones in rotation, right? And let's keep the other compensatory patterns quiet. Yeah? So really feel that. Really get a feel of that. Yeah? And maybe your movement, like maybe, here, let me come up a bit closer. Maybe your movement comes to about here. Like maybe that's it. That's okay. It's all good. It's what is, right? It's where it is. Okay, good. So now let's just do a couple more of those. Okay? Lovely. Okay, so now we're going to come up into a tree pose. So now with tree pose, the movement comes up like so. We start to move the leg bone into flexion at the hip. We're just going to start with that. Yeah, just start with that motion. And can you do just the smaller part of tree with a pelvis that is level, as opposed to coming way over to the side and dropping it like that? Can you just lift that leg bone in the hip socket? Not going far, we're going toward tree, we're not doing it quite yet. Yeah, okay. Now, can you rotate? I've got my toes on the floor. Can you rotate that leg bone in the pelvis? Notice how between my shirt and my pants, that's staying level. Yeah, yes, the weight is more so on my left leg, but everything is staying level, right? And just notice what rotation you have. Maybe your rotation is here. Maybe it's like, hey, why aren't you rotating? Maybe you wanted to rotate by doing this bigger movement because you're realizing now that, wow, maybe my leg bone doesn't move very much, which then maybe that says to you, huh, perhaps there's a correlation between that and my SI, or that and my back, or that and my knee, or that and my shoulder. Okay, so we're on the other side now. Okay, and then we're going to rotate. Okay, good. All right, let's take those legs wide again. Okay, and rotate, and we're going to come down. Okay, all right, now we're going to come back. Now, lots of times when we come into tree, we'll be coming up, and people will come down, and they'll pull the leg up. There's nothing wrong with doing that. Zero wrong. However, because this is a back to basics session, what I want you to play with is think about the actual movement to come into tree originates here at the hip and the knee. So we're going to be doing a little rotation and a little bit of flexion, and then the foot's coming onto that shin. right? And so I don't have to lean over. We want to help make the hip do the work, right? So if we come forward and grab that foot and we lift up, we're not enabling the hip to do the work actively. It becomes a passive member, right? And passive learning, it can have some benefit, but we're really wanting to help improve the actual control and coordination around this joint. So that's what we're going to be playing with today. And so I'm going to leave the hands out of it. And I'd like you just to play with coming up here, noticing that availability. Now, you might have a lot more. So then if you've got a lot more, watch the pelvis, watch my hip, watch my knee. Then you can bring it up and meet your hand and then place the foot. But it's all about what's going on through the hip. Yeah, that's the key, right? All right, so wherever you are at, whatever you want to do here, I'm going to just take my foot up to this point. So I'm going to play around with my hip and knee there. And then I can come in a tree. My pelvis is still facing forward. I can play around with that hip, that leg bone motion in the hip socket. I can get really clear about what's going on with my hip and the leg. Yeah? Really, 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 really clear. And then also notice things that are distal to where you're moving. Think about your jaw and your neck and your shoulder and how much other stuff kicked in to support the hip to do the movement. And what I'd love for you to play with is to not have those kick in. So only move as far. So we're going to be on this side now, rotating. Only be as far as you don't have to use that extra stuff. Right? Because up here, what does this have to do with my leg bone moving in the hip socket? If you really think about it, right? So if you're finding that as you load through, so I'm on my right side, if you load through your right side and you're needing to grip in order to do that, it's just food for thought. It becomes curious. And so what I'm suggesting is saying, okay, only load through that side without that happening. And I can offer that up because I can't see you in any shape, way, shape, or form. So I just want you to play with it as an idea. Okay, and then bring the leg up. Okay, notice your foot. Good, and then come on. Down. Good. All right. Now in standing, now notice what you feel. It's one of the reasons why I typically don't change people's tadasanas, because I want to notice what happens after they do a few movements and if how their posture is changes. Your posture is an embodiment of your structure. Your structure can change with a variety of good movement. All right. Let's take a side bend. Now the weight will be coming over to the leg that you're leaning toward, but just still feel this opposite leg. Feel that foot. Good. And then coming on up. Let's go to the other side. Good. And then come on up. All right. Now load more through one foot. Begin to raise the other. We're going to take ankle to the knee. So the articulating joint, leg bone and hip. There we go. That's the rotation. The knee initially went into flexion. And now the focus here is at the hip. And we take the ankle onto the knee. Okay. And now we can start to do a little bit of sitting. Now, the sitting is not us coming down from the top. It's the leg coming up to meet. So both are still hip flexion, right? I can do hip flexion by dropping my body down, my upper body down, or I can think of it as the leg coming up to meet the torso. Yeah. Good. And then come up. Good. All right. So now, other side. Ankle comes up. And sit. Now you can start to see how this begins to move towards eagle. You can also start to see how this might move into, oh, what's that one called? Flying pigeon, right? So as you get better and better and better ability at moving through here, then you can start to add a forward bend. Then you can start to add the actual flyingness to the pigeon, right? So these are all basic components to the bigger positions, right? So when we get those basic components, right, really, really get them, like truly get them, that's how things unfold. Not only do we move better and feel better, but we move towards these more complex movements that can be really quite fun. All right, let's see how you are in standing now. All right, lovely. Let's take the legs wide. Now we're going to come into warrior two. So with warrior two, the pelvis will move this way as we move that front leg. Yeah. So there will be a little bit of movement with that rotation of the leg. You might need to take your legs longer. But what we wanted to play with is as you rotate that leg, when you drop the foot, the pelvis doesn't drop too. Okay. When you come around, when you drop the foot, the pelvis is still there. So if you're noticing your pelvis is dropping, you might need to place something underneath your foot. You might need to take your stance closer. You get to decide what you need to do. You get to play. I mean, I can't make that decision for you because I can't see you. Yeah? Right? But the idea is that if you're rotating and then your foot's dropping and you move your pelvis, you're not setting yourself up really, really well. And you can create all sorts of issues through your SI and your back. All right, so here we are. You can rotate this back leg. You don't have to rotate this back leg. It's completely up to you what you want to do there, right? Okay, so from here now, let's take the arms out and then maybe just inch them up. Feel where you are through your heart out to your fingers. Feel where you are. Feel where you are. Yeah, so you might bring them up. You might keep them here. You might keep them here. You get to play. Good. So when I look down here at my knee, my focus is not on my knee. My focus was here between my hip and my foot. Now you could take a hand on the outside of the thigh, press the thigh into the hand. Because remember the knee, the top of the knee is the bottom of the leg bone that fits into the hip. And the bottom of the knee is the top of the shin bone that feeds into the ankle. So the knee really is a midway point between the hip and the ankle. So if we adjust at the knee, all sorts of goofiness can arise. But if we think about what's going on at the hip, because so many muscles that cross the hip control the knee or can impact the knee, we start here, we can make a huge amount of change to the knee. And then when we connect it to the foot, we then ratchet up the awesomeness that can happen. Okay, come on up. That was there for a bit of time. Okay, let's now do the other side. So I'm going to scooch my feet back a bit. Okay, now we're going to rotate. Good. Okay, now I want to actually take my legs a bit wider. Okay, so from here, let's lower down. Okay, and you get to play. Where do you want your arms to go? Do you want them to come out here, up here, here? You get to play. You want to turn your head to face. You want to take yourself lower. You can do all of that. You get to decide. But the idea is leg bone movement in the pelvis. Pelvis connection with the ribs. Just notice what you feel and make the choice based off of what you feel. Yeah. Center of the heel, ball of the foot, base of the pinky toe. You want to take the hand to the outside of the thigh, press that thigh out. Reconnect between the hip and the foot. Good, and then come up. Okay, and then bring yourself back to Tadasana. Now notice what you feel. So it's very possible that you're now feeling better and better than you did when you started, right? So the feeling of good is starting to come up, and maybe you were feeling a little crappy before. Maybe you just weren't feeling good, but you were feeling, now you're coming up to this place. So I'll talk about that in a moment. We're going to come into triangle now. Okay, so same setup. Okay, watch what happened with the pelvis and that foot. Yeah? Okay, now, from here, pubic bone to nose. Think about this connection. And let's take yourself into the position. Good? So here you've been like so. if you want. You can bring the arms into it. You don't have to bring the arms into it. You can take the arms here. You play. This is the articulating the arm bone in the shoulder socket. Or you can keep it right here, right there. Now come here, coming on up. Good. All right, let's rotate leg bones. Good. And the pelvis has come around. And now pubic bone to nose. So the movement is next. So you might only move this far. You might move this far. The other piece to watch for is what's going on at the knee, right? So if you're coming over and the knee starts to hyperextend, that's a bit of an indication that there's something not happening up and through here. You might not be quite aware of it. You might not feel it, but it's a place to go and explore. So you decide what you want to do with your arms. Feel your feet. Good. Okay, coming on up. So a triangle can get a really, really crappy reputation in the practice, but it's mostly because of how it's being done. And we're not actually focusing on improving the leg bone and the pelvis. Yeah? And that's partly what the aim is here. Okay, now come into standing and notice where you're at. So one of the things I'm going to mention when we're done is if you are feeling a lot better, is through the day today, I want you to notice when that good feeling starts to begin to fade, right? Because here's good and here's not so good or crappy or put whatever word here you want, is that there's this gap between the two. And this is what I call the whispers or the yellow lights, yeah? And so as you start to feel less good, you're starting to come into these whispers. And that's good because we can intervene at this point to help you get back to feeling good so you don't have to feel crappy, yeah? That's how we start to feel good more and more and more often when it comes to our movement and our practice. Good? It has so much relationship outside even our movement and our practice. Okay, come into tree again. So let's bring the weight over to one side. Let's rotate that leg bone and let's see if anything has changed. Okay, maybe you feel inspired to take that leg up. Yeah, just notice. Okay, good. And then come on down. Ready? Okay, let's go to the other side. Good. All right. And then come on down. Perfect. Now stand and feel. And notice. And just be aware of what's going on. What's up with your breath? What's up with your shoulders and your jaw? All right. Okay, now let's come down to the floor. I'm going to bring my mat a little bit closer. Okay. So on the floor, we're going to take ankle to the knee. So one leg's going to lift up and you're going to place the foot on the knee. But to do that, it's all about what's going on through the hip. So take the leg up and then do some rotation here at the leg bone in the hip socket, right? Like here. So then you place the foot on the knee. Lots of people, what they end up doing is watch my pelvis here. They start to shift at their pelvis. And that is a big, big, how do I want to say this? When I'm working with people who have QL, quadratus lumborum issues or psoas issues, it's a very common pattern that I see, is that instead of moving their leg bone in the hip socket, they're moving between the ribs and their pelvis, yeah? And then once the leg is there, now I want you to take one hand onto your bum and your other hand onto the front of your hip and just move your leg bone in rotation. And notice if you want to use the front of your hip, your hip flexors, to push your leg away. And for the fun of it, let's say don't do that. Let's not piston the leg away from your body. Instead, let the leg move in the hip socket and you ought to feel it in your bum, your rotators, when the leg is pushing away.
Good. Okay. And then ankle comes off of the knee. And then other side, leg comes up, ankle onto knee. Now what can become tricky is that we might get the one hip flexor quiet. So on the, this is my left side that's up. But then my right side, it's the one that wants to leverage to help support. So I want you to keep that left side, or the opposite side, the leg that's bent and not moving, keep that hip flexor quiet. The hip flexors will swoop in and help out in most situations. They're an awesome compensator. And it's like we've got to give them a high five and thank them for helping us live our life and getting the things done. Compensation, I talk about it an awful lot, I know. And it's good. Compensation, it's like part of us being human. Where it gets tricky is when we have pain. And what I have found is that when I help my clients reduce their compensation and they become aware of how they compensate, their pain drops and in many cases goes away. Okay, good. Take that ankle off. So that's why I focus on it so much. All right, let's come into a butterfly. So we're going to rotate the leg bones out and then coming back in. So this is not Baddha Konasana when the feet come right together. The feet are staying right where they are. And as the leg bones rotate, you're rotating on the outside of the foot. Good. And then you're going to come back. Now bring the hands into the front of the hip again. Those hip flexors are going to stay quiet. Yes, you are in hip flexion. Yes, you are. But it's not an active hip flexion. If I was asking you to do this with your feet off the floor, different story. But we're here, feet on the floor. You've brought yourself into hip flexion. It's not active anymore. The front of your hips in this position, they're not contracting to make the movement happen. It's not even an isometric contraction. They are at rest. So now as you begin to rotate the leg bones, they can stay at rest. So move only as far as they are at rest and allow the movement to be rotation of the leg bones in the hip socket. And again, you might be shocked as anything that your leg bones don't move very far. And if you've got back pain or SI pain or piriformis or QL or rib stuff or jaw stuff or anything stuff, that makes sense. It totally makes sense. Good. And then bring the legs back. Perfect. And easy breathing here. Feel that inhale and the exhale. And then we're going to roll it over and let's come on up. And if you've got a block handy, you can sit on the block or a bolster. I'm just going to sit on my heels to finish up. I want you just to breathe. So the process of getting well requires three things: breathing, movement, and stillness. And those three things help cascade a whole other bunch of things, which are also obviously necessary for healing and recovery. Start with those three: breathing, movement, stillness. Pay attention to how you're moving and what parts of your body that you are moving so you can get clear on what's actually working and not working. Notice your breathing. Do you brace? Do you hold? Help yourself breathe. And then as you do this part of the practice, you'll become quieter and quieter and quieter inside. And as you do, you're going to feel and become aware of more. And that is what's going to help you progress on the path of recovery. So from here, let's bring the hands together and breathe in with ease and out with gratitude. Namaste. If you need any help with understanding and feeling your body, send me a message either through our website at functionalsynergy.com or direct message me and let's have a chat. Alrighty? Take good care. We will see you tomorrow morning.